Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Start with the name of Allah Almighty. Assalamu alaikum students, my name is Ishan Ali and welcome to the Future Study Phase 3 Lecture 2 Mathematics of Class 5. Previously we discussed what is the HCF and LCM in short. In this lecture we study HCF in more detail. And also we previously discuss about what is a factor, what is a multiple, what is mean by divisible, test of divisibility, rules of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9 and 11. Now come to the today's topic, HCF. What is HCF? HCF is called highest common factor, which is the number, greatest number in the group of common factors of two or more numbers. So for finding HCF of two or more numbers, we first need to find the prime factors of those numbers. For example, prime factors of 195. So I do step by step here how to find the prime factor. We need to find the prime factor of 195. In this area, you always write prime number from lowest to highest. For example, the lowest prime number is 2, and then 3, then 5, then 7, and up to so on. So 195 is not divisible by 2. Then we take prime factor 3. 3, 6 are 18. 19 minus 18 is equal to 1. 1 equal to the 5. Now it's become 15. Now 3 5s are 15. It is now completely divisible by 3. Then we take the next prime factor as 5. 5 1s are 5 and 5 3s are 15. When 1 is carried to the right. Now 13 is a prime factor, so it only divides by 13. So the prime factors of 195 are 3, 5 and 13, which we can write in this form. 195 is equal to 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 15. If you multiply 3, 5 and 13, we get 195. Next. How to find the HCF by prime factorization method. In prime factorization method, we first need to find the prime factors of these numbers. For example, we are going to find the HCF of 64, 148 and 60. First, we need to find the prime factors of these numbers. For example, 64. We previously see that how to find the prime factor. 2, 3 is 6, 2, 2 is 4. Then we take 2 again, 2, 1 is 2, and 1 is carry, 12, now it's 12, 2, 6 are 12. Now we take another 2 because 16 is also divisible by 2, 2, 8 is 16, 8 is also an even number, so it again divisible by 2. So 2, 4 is 8. 2 2s are 4 and 2 1s are 2. The prime factors of 148 are 2, 2 and 37. 2 7s are 14, 2 4s are 8, 2 3s are 6, now 1 is carry. 2 7s are 14 and 37 is a prime number. So it divides only by 1 and the number itself, which is 37. Now we find the prime factors of 60. 2, 3, 30s are 16. 2, 15, 2, 1s are 2. 1 is carry. 2, 5s are 10. 3, 5s are 15. And 5, 1s are 5. Now the prime factors of 64 is 2, multiply 2, multiply 2, multiply 2, multiply 2, and last is 2. 6 times 2, and the prime factor of 148 is 2, 2, and 37. And prime factors of 60 is equal to 2 times 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5. Now HCF is the product of all the common factors of these three numbers. Now you can see the 2 is common. 2 is common in all three numbers. This 2 is common to all three numbers, and again 2 is common to all these numbers. 37 is not common to all three numbers. 3 is also no common. 5 is also no common. And these two has no common factor again in these numbers. So HCF is a product of common factor of the required number. So these are the common numbers 2 and 2 times 2, which is equal to 4. Now HCF of 64, 148 and 60 is 4, which means 64, 148 and 60 are divisible by 4. Next, we need to find the HCF by division method. In previous slide, we see that how to find the HCF by prime factorization method. In this question, we see that how to find the HCF by division method. So let's see this. Step number 1, take the largest number as dividend. The largest number among these three numbers is 93. So I take 93 largest number as dividend. It is not necessary, but it's convention that we take the largest number as dividend. This is a dividend, and the second largest number is 54, so we take it as a divisor. So 54 ones are 54, then we subtract, we get the remainder 39. The next step to find the HCF by division method is we change the remainder into divisor and the old divisor into dividend. Let's see. The remainder becomes divisor, and the divisor becomes dividend. So we again divide 54 by 39. 39 ones are 39, and the remainder is 15. Repeat these two steps above until we get the zero remainder. Now remainder becomes divisor, and the divisor becomes, or divisor becomes dividend. Now 15 to the 30, then we subtract 30 from 39, we get 9. So 9 is our divisor, new divisor, and 15 is our dividend. So 9 ones are 9, 15 minus 9, 6. Now 6 is our divisor, and 9 is our, 6 is our divisor, new divisor, and 9 is our dividend. 6 ones are 6, remainder is 3. Now 3 to the 6. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Now we get the 0 remainder. So HCF of 93 and 54 is 3. Now there is another number left which we find the HCF of this number. The HCF of these two numbers is 3. Now we have to find the HCF of the three numbers. So the last divisor still remains same, and the new number is the dividend. So 3 13s are 39, remainder is 0. So the last divisor is our HCF. As last divisor is 3, so HCF is 3. HCF of 39, 93 and 54 is equal to 3. So it is done for today. Today we learned that what is the HCF. HCF is the highest common factor. First we find the HCF. First we find the factors. Then we find common factors from them, and then we find the highest of these common factors. So next, how to find? We learned how to find the prime factors, and next we find we learned how to find HCF by two methods: prime factorization method and also division method. Your diary for today is page number 35 to 36, question number 4 and 6. For practice plus written on neat workbook. You have to do all parts of these questions. I think there is 2 or 3 parts in each question. So see this video again and again if you have any confusion, or still you have any confusion, you can feel free to ask with me. Thanks for watching. If you have any question, you can ask in the required time. Allah Hafiz.